10 great camera and photography tips coming up. Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto and I'm a photographer. And in this video, I'm going to share 10 great photo and camera tips. And the best part is that these tips will work with every camera and for every photographer. These are random tips in no particular order. Let's get started. Number one, when changing lenses, always keep your camera mount facing down. It's never a good idea to change lenses in a dirty or dusty environment, but dust can end up on your sensor every time you remove the lens. And my tip is to keep the mount facing down whenever you change lenses, then you're less likely to get dust on your sensor because the sensor is facing down. I do that every time it's possible, and usually it is possible to keep the camera or the mount facing down when I change lenses. Number two, whenever you remove the card or the battery from your camera, leave the battery and card door open. I think it happens to all of us sooner or later that we forget the card or the battery at home when we go out and try to take pictures, but obviously we can't take any pictures because we don't have a card or a battery in our camera. But whenever you remove the card or the battery from your camera, leave those doors open, and then it's very easy for you to notice if there is a card or battery in the camera, and you are less likely to forget those when you go out to take a photo walk or whatever. Number three, always have your camera ready in your hand, not in your bag. If you have your camera in your bag, you are less likely to take it out if you see something remotely interesting, but you will never know if that remotely interesting would be a picture of a lifetime because you never took that picture because you thought it's too much trouble to unpack your camera from your bag. And another reason is that if you see something really interesting happening in front of you, you might be late because you need to first unpack your camera. So always have your camera ready in your hand and not in your bag when you are taking a photo walk or you are planning to take great photographs. Number four, when you're out there photo walking or looking for great shots, do that and nothing else. Don't use social media, put your phone away, don't chimp your pictures, leave that to a later moment. Just concentrate on the job, on your pictures, on what is happening around you or on your subject, whatever it is. If you need a break, go to a cafe, have a coffee, relax a bit, but when you are back out taking pictures, do just that and nothing else. Concentrate on your photography and nothing else while you are taking pictures. Every time you do something else, use social media, chimp your pictures, a great moment can just go by without you noticing it. So concentrate on your photography whenever you are doing it and do nothing else. Number five, always carry the minimum possible amount of gear with you. First, because the more gear you have, the heavier it is and it's going to drag you down. And also, the more gear you have, the more likely you are to just fiddle with your gear and it's going to hold you back. It's going to take your concentration away from your photography. So the less gear you have, the better results you're going to get. My minimum setup is, and my usual setup is just one camera body and one prime lens, but of course it doesn't have to be as extreme as that. Whatever works for you, but try to figure out the minimum gear setup that works for you and the minimum setup that you can work with and get some results. I guarantee that is going to also improve your results. Number six, preset your camera settings so that they are perfect when the action finally happens. What I mean by this is that whenever you are taking a photo walk or whatever it is that you are shooting, preset your camera settings as close to perfect as possible. For example, in street photography, you might be standing on a street corner waiting for something to happen. And if you preset your exposure, even your focus, then all you have to do is to lift the camera up and grab the shot of your lifetime when the action finally happens. Nothing is worse than to realize that the shutter speed was too long or whatever when that action happens and you lose that shot of a lifetime. So always keep your settings as close to perfect as possible and your camera ready for that perfect shot, whatever it is that you are trying to capture. Number 7, look around, observe and see the light. Even if you don't have a camera with you, still observe what is happening around you, observe how the light falls and observe what you see around you. I do that all the time. I make imaginary pictures with my eyes and with my mind. Even if I don't have a camera, I make imaginary like frames and imagine how they would look as a photograph if I don't have a camera with me. And I think it's so deep in my head that I can't not do that. Even if I wanted to, I just keep seeing pictures. For example, if I'm sitting in a cafe, I keep observing the people around me and everything around me, and I keep making those imaginary pictures in my mind. And I recommend you do the same. It's a great practice, and it's gonna train your eyes and your brain to find those great shots whenever you have your camera with you. Number 9, look at pictures. Look at all kinds of pictures. Look at pictures that you like. Look at pictures that you don't like. And always when you see a picture you like or don't like, try to figure out why you don't like or why you like that particular picture. If you do that, it's going to improve your photography. It's going to make you a better photographer. My preferred method to look at pictures, or my preferred way to look at pictures, is to look at photo books, because a printed picture is always the best picture in my opinion. I either buy books or I borrow them from a library. Number 10, glue your SD cards. Yes, you heard me right. SD cards, I think, are by far the most popular type of cards these days. But the design is far from perfect. There is that little write protection plastic tab that can easily move to a wrong position, and if you insert that card into a camera, you can't take any pictures. My tip is to put a little bit of glue into that slot and glue the write protection tab so that your card is always ready to be used. Whenever I get a new card, I always glue that a little tab so that it can't move anymore. Except with these Sony Tough cards, it's not necessary because the Sony designers were smart enough to remove that or delete that write protection tab altogether, and these cards don't have that same problem. But my tip is to glue that write protection tab so it won't move or it won't break, and you never have to worry about that anymore. That's it, 10 random photo camera tips. I hope you enjoyed them. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.